You know, good. It's good. You're working, Jack. I'm okay, Jack. Yes. Training camp has been good. I'm happy to be working back with my father. And I work with my father and Roger, you know, but come fight night, my dad will be in my corner. And I'm happy.
You've been one to predict knockouts in the past. Any predictions Saturday?
Well, I've been in training camp, you know, I feel like I'm punching, you know, super hard. I've had a long training camp. It's been a good training camp, though. Everything has played out well in training. And like I said before, I can't wait for the fight.
I have to ask you, did you expect his father to go off like that? I mean, what's your reaction to what?
Actually, I was texting. I'm just showing him. I was texting Miss Jackson when he's up there talking. I was saying, sexy Miss J, and she texted me back, and you know it. You know, and she said, "That's me, LOL." So, you know, I don't have to fight his father. You know, I'm there to fight the fighter. And like I told my dad, you know, you gotta carry yourself in the classroom. But you know, when I was young at one particular time, I'm a lot older now, so I'm a lot wiser. You know, I know what I bring to the table. You know. Like I said before, and when I was young, seeing a wild Floyd Mayweather, but I'm a lot older now. You know, my kids are teenagers now, so I can't be conducting myself in a disorderly fashion. It's okay to trash talk sometimes and still get people excitement, but it's a time and a place for everything.
So that might be the calmest you've ever been at a press conference a couple days before a fight, because a lot of people were surprised. You know, you seemed very calm on stage.
Because, you know, like I said before, Dave Mayo had a chance to see me box the other day, and I wasn't boxing a 3-minute round. Paying for Fight Hype had a chance to see me box the other day, and I feel like I'm in tip-top shape, tip-top condition, and I'm ready to fight. You know, I don't have to sit right here and bad-mouth his father. I don't have to do that because, only God can judge me. You know, I'm more like basically, like I said before, if I did or I didn't do a crime, I served my time. And I love my family, I love my children, and I have nothing negative to say about the mother of my children. You know, we don't know who over here who's ever had problems with. Somebody got a problem with their sister. Their sister could be drinking. They could say, "Yo, grab the arm, relax." But guess what? If you grab them, tell them to relax, that's considered domestic violence. So, you know, only God can judge me.
Hey, Floyd, when he was going off like that on that rant, does that bother you at all, or you just sort of take it as the way the promotion goes?
Well, you know, I've been here so
long. I know.
I've been here so many times, and we done been pushing and shoving. We done seen fights break out, stuff get thrown.
I just never heard anybody say that so pointed to you about anything, so I didn't know if it took you by surprise, or you just shook it off, or didn't care.
I just say a prayer for him. You know, I just say a prayer for him. I'm not upset at all. I'm not upset at all. I just keep my composure. And when it comes time for the fight, I do what I do best. I can fight.
Floyd, clearly your father was upset about it because he came up afterward and actually went after Ruben. Is there any concern there?
Both fighters. You know, I'm pretty sure his father loves him, and my father loves me, and those things happen, you know. But like I said before, there's a difference between, I'm older now, so I look at things in a different way. There's a difference between, like I said before, there's a difference between, you got class and you got trash, you know what I'm saying? And like I said before, I never want to get no piercings, no tattoos, carry myself in a classy way. 30 months, my career is over. You know, rack up my 6 victories, and hopefully do commentating and keep the sport of boxing alive.
But when you say...